Hello and welcome to this video of the course Answers and Solving in Practice, where we are going to do exercise 1D on Clark's completion and loop formulas of the axiomatic characterization part of the course. So here we have this program P, and I've copied it right here. And the first thing we have to do is to find the Clark's completion. And for this, we start with A, and for A, we will have A if and only if B and F, or not C and not E. Now, for B, we have B if and only if C and not E, or not E. Next, for C, we will have C if and only if A and B or E. Next, we have that D, given that there's a unique rule for D, we will say D if and only if not E. And similarly for the E, we will have E if and only if not D. Now, the F again is similar, so we have F if and only if A and not G. And then, after you have gone through all the atoms in the head, also we must look for atoms that do not occur in any head, like G, and then we will have G if and only if false, right? And this is the same as saying that G must be false. Good. Okay, so this is the first part of the exercise. So now let's find the positive dependency graph, the loops, and the loop formulas. And let's start here by writing the graph. So from here we have an edge from B to A and from F to A. Then here we have no positive literals in the body, but here we have this link from C to B. No positive literals in the body, and here we have from A to C and from B to C. A to C and B to C, so we add the edge in the other direction. Here we have the E to the C. And the A to the F. So we have this loop here. Good, and now, okay, and we also have the edge with the G that doesn't need, has no incoming or outgoing edges. Okay, and let's write this just with mathematical notation here. So we have the nodes A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. And now we have the edges B, A, F, A, C, B, A, C, B, C, E, C, and A, F. Okay, and I close it here, and let's just check that we have how many, let's count the number of edges that we should have, so, and this is the same as the number of positive positive literals that we have. Yes, but okay, it could be the case that if we have this rule and also the rule A, if F, not E, then there is only a link between F and A, even when F appears in two bodies whose head is A, right? So we have to be careful with that. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So we expect to have 7 edges. This is what we have right here. And this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. I will just repeat what I have said. Suppose that we had now here A, if F, and not E. Then even when there would be 8 positive literals in total in all the bodies, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We would have only 7 edges, right? Because there's the edge from F to A. There is only one, and it it happens, it is there because of two different rules, right? In this case. Okay, but this was just for explaining that one should be careful with that test. Not that one thing that you have done something incorrect while everything is fine. Good. Then let's go back now to here to find the loops. And for this, there is no, we can start checking just by every single node whether there's a loop to it, a rule that leads to itself, and we don't have any. Then we can look for the sets of two elements, and then we see here A and F, they are connected to each other, so then we have those loops. We have A, F, and B, C. And then we have to look for bigger loops. So, okay, here we don't have nothing of that can be in a loop. But now these three form a loop, right? Because from the C I can go to the B, then to the A, and then back to the C. And then I can go from any of them to itself. So we have A, B, and C. Now let's see if we start with... and then basically every cycle that goes through loop 2A can be extended to F, right? Because we can go from C to B to A, then to F, then back, and then here. So we have A, B, C, and F. And, okay, and it could be, one could think, okay, maybe with B and A and just one of these, there would also be a loop, but not, right? If we just consider these two and B, there's no way from for example, there's no way from B to go, sorry, F to go to B without going through C, right? And similarly for the C, there is no way from the C to go through the F without going through the B, right? Again, there's no way of going from the C to F if it doesn't go through the B, right? Because I'm telling you this because one has to be careful that one writes down all the loops. So then you have to check these things, whether if I consider, for example, these three, I can go from B to the, from, for example, what was it here that we couldn't do, from F to B, right? And this is not possible if we just consider these three nodes. Good, okay. Then let's move on and do the part about loop formulas. And then we start with A, with this loop, AF, and we write the corresponding loop formula. So we have A of F, then what happens? So here we have these two rules for A or F, and this has the A, this has the F, hence this must hold, not C or not E. Not C and not E, right? And intuitively what this is telling us is that if either A or B belong to a set, then this body must hold. Because I think it's perhaps easier to understand it the other way. If this body doesn't hold, then the only way we could have either A or F is but if these some of these two bodies were satisfied. But in this case, again, if this doesn't hold, we can only get any of them using the other, right? So then it's impossible that we are that we derive them, because for deriving them we need them. Okay, next step. So we have B or C, then we have these four rules. So here we have the C in the body, and here we have the B. Then these two bodies, one of these two bodies must hold. Either we have not D or E. And again, the reasoning is the same. If these two bodies do not hold, then we cannot have B or C, because for having them, we must use them already, right? So there's no way to derive them. And next, we have the loop A, B, C, and then in this case, these are the rules, all this, A, B, C, let me see, yes, and then this has the B, this has the C, this has both A and B, and then one of these three bodies here must hold, right? So then either we have not C and not E, O, we have non D, O, we have E. Okay, and then in the next one we have A, O, B, O, C, O, F. And then these are all the rules. And basically, as before, here we have the B, here the C, here A and B, here we have the A. So then again, one of these three must hold. Not C and not T, or not D or E. Okay, then we are done with the loop formulas and we can move on to finding the stable the supported models, that is the models of the completion of the formula. Okay, then here the first thing is that we have this rule that basically is telling us that G is false. And we add it here. So we can mark it like that here, and we can also say that in this part G is false. So basically we know now that F is equivalent to A. Okay, but now also what happens is that we do not know anything else about other atoms, right? It's not that we can fire any of these equivalents. Hence, we will have to reason by cases, and then what we can do, for example, is to reason by cases on the atom D, because when we have the D, we can make a decision on the E also, for example, but you could try with other atoms. Then here, okay, let's do this. So we have not D on this side and D on the other side. So basically here we are going to look for supported models that do not contain D, and here with the ones that contain D, right? And in these ways we are going to cover all possible supported models. So, okay, let's move on. Now with not D, this becomes true, hence E has to be true. And then, yeah, we have that D is false because we have the E. We are fine with respect to this. And now, since we have the E, we derive the C here. So C has to be true. And what else we have here? So given that we have not D, then this part of the equivalence is true. Hence, this also has to be true. So we have the B. Yeah, good. And now what are we left with respect to the A? Okay, here we do not have the not E, we have E, hence we can, this disjunct will not hold. And here we have the B, but we don't have the F. So now if we analyze it, what we see is that basically this is true. Then what we have is A if and only if, sorry, A if and only if F on this side, and F if and only if A on this side. So we know that now we will have two options. This is telling us A is equivalent to F, so we will have two options, one with not F, not A, and another with F and A. And we can see this doing it more like step by step if we decide now to look for solutions without A and with A. So if we do not have the A, then this is false, hence F has to be false. And similarly here, if A is false, F has to be false. And on the other side, it's the other way around. If A is true, the only way to become true is if F is true, or also here if A withdraws the F from the other side. Good, and now, so in principle, we would expect this to be two supported models, and now, but before we move on, let's confirm it, just checking that all the equivalences hold, right? So then, this will hold for the whole tree, right? So we don't have to check it anymore, because this part is false, and this part is also false here. Now let's check with this one. So here, not D is true, and E is true, so we are good. So here not E is false because of the E, and D is also false. So then we are good. And what else? We can also decide already just looking at this part that the C is okay, because on this part we have that E hold, hence this part is true. And for C, this is also true, right? So both parts of the equivalence have the same value, then the equivalence is satisfied. And now for this, also this part is true because we have not D, and this part is true because B holds, right? So then we are only left to check these two. And on this side, then F is false, hence this is false, this was false, so the whole thing is false, and A must be also false, and this is what we have. And similarly here, A is false, hence the conjunction is false, and F is also false, so then the equivalence is satisfied because both sides have the same truth value, and if we make A and F true, then also the equivalence hold, right? Good, now let's move on to the other side. So what happens now if we assume that D holds? Then with the D, we should have not E. Oh, let me clean now this because now we have all the marks from the previous reasoning. So let's continue here. Good, then what we have is that D is true. Oops. Hence, E has to be false. And here, given that this doesn't hold, we must have that E is false. And this is what we had written already there. Nice. Now we are left with A, B, C, and F. Let's see what can we obtain from here. Given that we have not E, this is simplified. Given that we have D, this is simplified. Here, we get rid of this. Then here, not E appears there. But it doesn't seem that we can derive anything easily, right? Because here we have F is equivalent to A. Then A is equivalent to either this or this. Here we have that B is equivalent to C, and that C is equivalent to A and B. But we cannot derive the truth value of any of those atoms, right? So then we have to move on and make some choice on other atom. And here it's a bit unclear what would be a good choice. We can just try with the A, that is the first one that we have there. And the solvers, when they try to solve this problem, they have heuristics to decide on which atom to decide. But we are doing it here a bit randomly. So let's look for solutions without the A and with the A. So if, let's go now for through this side. So if A is false, then F is going to be false. Then what else we have here? So if A is false, then this part is false and C has to be false. Let's see what else. So then we also have that if A is false here, then both of these have to be false. But then it should be the case that we have the C, right? So then it seems that there's no solution that has not A. And let's have a look again at it. So if let's get this, so really we don't need, just from the moment we know that A doesn't hold, then we know that C doesn't hold from here, right? Because the A false makes this false, and the E false makes this false. So C must be false from here, and this is what we have written here, right? But on the other hand, if A is false, then both these have to be false. And for these to be false, C must hold, right? Because if we make the C false, then this part would be true, and A should be true. Hence, now we know that there is no supported model with the D and without the A, right? I repeat this. So if we have not A, then C must be false from this rule. And if we have not A, C must be true from this rule, given that we have not E. Because otherwise, this would, if C was false, it would force us to have the A. Okay, good. And then we can go through the other side when we have made this choice on the A. And let me then clean again this that I have here. So because otherwise I'm going to get confused with the new with this other branch, right? And you will also get confused. So let me do this. Ta-da, I think this should be it. So no, the C was not there. Okay, so I think this is it. I have G, D, E, A, D, E, G, 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 D, E, A. Good. So then now we make the A true. And okay, this we have to delete also. So now with the A true, F becomes true, right? We have the F here true and the A here true. So, but now we are left also in a situation where we cannot derive anything. We have A if and only if B or not C, right? Because we have not E and we have this F here. Okay, actually, I think this may be confusing to you because I have the not E crossed here while here I'm underlining, but both are satisfied. So let me then just clean this and use the same symbol to say that both are satisfied. Good. So then here we know that A holds if and only if B or not C hold, B if and only if C, and C if and only if A. But we cannot see, it's not clear what we could deduce from there. So then let's reason again by cases. And given that before we chose the A, now let's choose the B. And then on this side, if B is false, if B does not belong to the stable model, then what we have is that, okay, without the B, now C must be false, right? And then this is fine also with this one, because now if C is false, then B must be false from here. And now A is true, and it is made true by this not C and not E, right? So then this is fine. So then this looks like a supported model, but before we finish, let's just check again whether it satisfies all the equivalence. So with this, we are fine with not G. With these two, we are fine with these two. Now with this rule for F, F is true, and here we have A and not G. Yes, we have A and not G. Now let's see for the C. C is false, and this part is false because we have not B, and this part is false also because of the E that we have not E there. Now, on this side, I have not B, so B is false. And looking here, this is also false. And this is also false because we have not C, right? So then on this part is false, and this other part is also false. Good. And then let's check here. This part is true. And here we have B and F. This part is false, but this part is going to be true, right? Because not C is true and not T is also true, right? So then we have checked that this is a supported model. And now if we come here to the other part, now, oops, let's clean this again and delete what we added now because of the C and the B. And now with the B here, then, or let's come here with the B here, we derive that C must be true. Nice. So then again, now that B and C are true, so this is satisfied. So let's check now the model. So these, okay, these three are already satisfied by this assignment. Now here we have that, given that we have A and F, this is also satisfied. And now what happens here? C is true and A and B is true. B is true and we have here C and not E is true, so we are good. And here we have A is true and B and F is true. So then all equivalences are satisfied, and we can say that this is a supported model. Hence we have 1, 2, 3, and 4, and let's write them down here. So we have this B, C, A, and also A, B, C, E, F. A, D, okay, let me move this a bit, otherwise I will not have enough space here. So we have A, D, F, and we also have A, B, C, D, F. Good, so these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And now we have to see just for the last part. So now we have found the models of the completions. Now we have defined the stable models. And for this, it's enough to check which of these satisfies all loop formulas, right? Then let's move this a bit here below. And let's check each of them. So B or C, B, C, A, let's see here. So it satisfies, it doesn't satisfy this body, right? Because it doesn't have the A or the F. It satisfies here B or F, but it also satisfies the other part, right? It says if you satisfy this, you should satisfy one of these, but we are good because we have the E. Here, similarly, we have B or C, so then we satisfy this, but we also satisfy this part with E. Now I'm talking about this one, right? And here we have also the B and the C, but we also have the E from the other side. Hence, B, C, E is a stable model. Now let's check the A, B, C, E, F. So then here, this is satisfied because we have the C, the F, sorry. So we should have not C and not E, but we have the E. Hence, this is not a stable model, right? And now, just to understand this a bit, looking at the program, what happened here is that we have B and C, but we have not, so we have the, sorry, no, we have, sorry, I got lost here. We have A and F, but this body doesn't fire, doesn't give us anything. We cannot use it for proving because we have the E, right? So then the only way of having A and F is with these two rules, but these two rules use them. Hence, there is no way that we can really prove both of them, right? That's why this is not a stable one. Okay, let's move on to here, to ADF. So here we have the A, so we must have not C and not A, and this is indeed the case. And here, what else? We do not have B or F, so then we are good here. So here we have the A, so then we must have some of these, and indeed we have not C and not E. And the similar thing will happen here, that we have the A, and actually also the F here, but we are good because we have not C and not A, right? So then this means that, given that this is a supported model, and satisfies all formulas, it's also a stable model. And now for this one, let's see. So we have the A here. Hence, we should have not C and not E, but we have the C, right? So then this is not a stable model, and these are the two that we have, right? Again, the reason we can do similar reasoning as before. Here we have the root for A and F, but we do not have not C and not A. So then the only way of having A and B is using these two rules, but they need them before. So then there is no, there is not going to be a way of proving those two atoms. Okay, nice. So then I think this finishes the exercise. It took a bit of time, but I hope you have enjoyed it and you have understood it. So then see you in another video. Ciao!